So today we are going to see the configuration for mail server. So what is the mail server? Why we require mail server? And what is the importance of mail server? Mail server means like you use Outlook, Gmail, Google, Hotmail, anything which you send from one place to another place via electronic media, a medium of communication is called a email server. Through email server only will send. But SAP has given you option. SAP has given you the option. Which option? You can send mails from SAP also. Like as we discussed in last all our topics, SAP created this, SAP created that. They create background drop, they create some reports, they create some spool requests and all. So why? What is the use of all those things? If they create and keep with them, it's none of use. If they create and send via post, none of, nothing is on use. So what SAP does, whenever spool is getting created or reporting is generated, like report for last day consumption of material, money received, money payments made, okay, goods received, goods supplied, okay, goods received at each Singori godown, material consumes at each godown, okay, final product, what was the final product they made each day, the all entries they made in systems, who, end users throughout the globe. Like if your offices throughout the India, throughout the globe, each every person has to make the entries. At the, what is the use of making this entry is in the night after 12 o'clock in non-working hours, a purpose in a program, take all the data and create one report and summarize it, okay, and convert it into PDF file and send it to a particular email ID. So by that what happened every day morning when the manager, when the CEO, when the director wakes up, he just check his email, what was done yesterday, what is his position of the company yesterday. Now in each company minimum there are minimum 800 to 3000 mails sent every day. 800 or 1000 mails to 3000 mails sent every night to all the people, all the leads of the company, depending upon the size of the company. And is one more compulsion? Is it here written compulsion? You have to send each and mail to everybody. No. This mail is for somebody, this mail is for somebody, this mail is for this person. You have to segregate which mail has to send to which person. Depending upon that, that mail automatically go and file sits in its inbox only. By that, when he opens the mail, if he's a finance guy, he can see his finance report. If he's a purchase guy, he can see purchase report. If he's a director, he see finance report. If he's a CEO, he see profits and loss of report. Like depending upon criteria cadre, you have to send reports every day. This is what we need to discuss. We are going to discuss today how we are going to set up a mail server in SAP environment. Like SAP given the port, like we have HTTP port, we have HTTPS port, and we have SMTP port. HTTP port means hypertext protocol, and this HTTPS means hypertext protocol, secure for payments and all, and SMTP, single mail transfer protocol, that is only for sending and receiving mails through from outside and from outside to inside, vice versa. The port define is 25. HTTP, HTTP, the by default port is 81, 80, 80, 81, 80, and this HTTPS default port is 443. And for this SMTP, we have port called 25. Default port is 25. We have for mail server. Okay, we are working on that today. How we are going to configure things on mail server? How we are going to send mails from outside SAP to outside SAP? That you have to configure this only once. You have to configure this only once. Not like you all the time have to configure this. No, you have to configure only once and leave it. Then people will start using this whenever they feel to send mails to anybody. Okay, now we'll see a live scenario how this things works on a construction environment, because there are different things or for different environment. We are going to see like there are different industries are there. Depending upon that, the criteria will be changed. Like manufacturing plant, textile plant, media plant, advertising agency. For all those things, different things are the input. But today we are going to see a construction company input. If you are going to see how it's work for construction site. This is a live scenario where I was implement this thing, mail server for this one of the prestigious construction firm. Okay, like you see what all things they take care of. They take care of diesel consumption. Here what happened, whenever you talk about diesel construction industry, they need to have some vehicles always going here and there. For that, they require diesel. And whatever the machinery they run for the whole day in all the sites, they require diesel. Diesel is the most important part. Like if you purchase 100 liters of diesel every day and you put only 20 liters, matlab it is not, the system is not, you are not maintaining account properly. So here what happened, whatever diesel you purchase, you have to make an entry. You have to take money from the accountant and he make entry key, I paid for 60 liters. Then you have to pay for 60 liters of diesel and you have to consume that. You know that each and every vehicle give the average depending upon some gives that 10, 12, 13 lakh, depending upon that you can pay for the whole day, 60 liters is being consumed for this particular vehicle. Like that we have 60, 70 plants, each and every plant, they purchase diesel every day for their own vehicles, for the machineries, for other uses. So when 60 plants purchase this diesel, so on 60 plants, people are there who sits and make entry. We purchase this much diesel, we made this much money. Entry made and diesel purchased. And rented machineries. Rented machinery means what? Construction firm require many kinds of different machineries which company doesn't have and they didn't own that. You have to rent them. And most probably, they are charging on hourly basis. They're charging on mainly hourly. This is the main thing. They're charging on hourly basis. Here, what happened? If you consume rent a machine per day, and the cost of rent is 50,000 to 1 lakh per day per machinery. So you should know by paying 1 lakh rupees, this much work has to be done by this machine. Otherwise, it means that machine is not utilized for 8 hours. When that machine, the work is complete, then only accountant, the make entry, we have paid 1 lakh and this work has been done yesterday or any day, they make proper entries after seeing that that much work has been done, because we are paying 50,000 to 1 lakh rupees per day per machinery. Like 60 plants, hired some machineries, different. Some cost 10,000, some cost 20,000, some cost 40,000 per day, per week, depending upon that. But they calculated made only, but three hours work. 3 hours with, they'll pay only, they paid for three hours. If the 5 hours, they paid only for 5 hours. Depending upon that, how much utilization you have done, that they will be made. And material consumption, each and every material, like each and every plant, construction plant required some material to work on, like steel, cement, different kinds of things. Whatever to consume, they make entry key. I gave this material to this guy after taking that PR, purchase acquisition. Okay, I want this material. You have to make all the entries properly. And material issued by the set. What HO does, they send materials to each and every site on every day basis. Because they have the report, this site doesn't have these materials, you have to send it. Depending upon that, they send materials to each and every site and issue from stores. What are things on daily basis, what they issue from their each and every plant as this own store for secure the materials. they whatever they issued, they also make proper entries. So every day 6 o'clock in the morning, each manager at the receiver receives a mail of yesterday works done. In the same case, you have in some cases your mail gets failed. Okay, so what happened? Every day they receive a mail. They practice now. But one day your mail gets failed. Okay, if you schedule a job at 3 a.m. in the morning. Okay, at that time there was a network issue, or file system gets full, or shut down the server for some emergency activity. Because of these reasons, mail will not get triggered. Okay, so what ABAPR write a program with the help of table provided by the functional team. With the functional team, the MMHD PPL functional team, they know the entry with their mailing in MM. The entry goes and sits in which table, what value to be fetched. They will give proper documentation to the ABAPR, write a program, name it as material consumption, make it as material issue, make it as payment received, make it as payment made. Like depending upon, they will get that fresh data every day for each and every module. After running program, they convert spool request into PDF, then send it to the mail, send to the user. They maintain a table in which they maintain all the users. But they maintain a users. How many users are there? There are 500 users. But how many mails are there? There are 3000 mails to send this 500 users. So they maintain a table, user one, this mail. User two, this mail. That they segregate all 3000 mails to each and every user. So whenever you trigger that thing, it reads the table and see the values on each table. And depending upon that, it fires the mails to the particular person at given point of time. Okay. Now, what all the T codes you are going to see today? We are going to see SCOT and SOST. These are the two transition codes you are going to see today. SCOT SCOT and SOAT SOST for mail configuration part. Okay. We have to work with SMTP server in which we use sending mail. Default port is 25. We'll see when we start our server, we'll see how to work with that for sending and receiving mails. Okay. SMTP simple mail transfer protocol port is 25. Okay. And here what happened? You can maintain hours and minutes. Means if you give 10 minutes, if you give your 10 minutes, the mail will send each time after 10 minutes. If you receive 30 over here, the mail will be sent 30 minutes. For example, like 12:10 to 12:19, by the time we start the server. For example, here mail triggered for every 10 minutes. Here what happened? Mail gets triggered at 12:10. For example, till 12:19, whichever 12:19:59, whichever mails comes from all the places, it sits in a queue. It may be 10 mails, it may be 20 mails, it may be 2000 mails. It will not send anything because time is specified is 10. What happened when 12:19:59 hours 12:20:01 second it fires all fine on there fine on even there huh lala it fired all the mails to the concerned email IDs. It fired mails to the all the concerned mail IDs. 1230, 1240, same thing. But when you test your server at 1222, you think the mailing server is not working. Don't get confused at the time. You just go and check the timings. What is the intervals? What is the interval? 10, 15. Wait till the time and check the server at that time. At that time, server, at that time, mail will go. When you test, first you have to test what is the timing specified. Otherwise, you get confused key. Why my mails are not triggered, whether my configuration is perfect or not. You need configuration perfect. If somebody changes, then only it will happen. Otherwise, it will work properly for the whole thing, okay?
Sir, general question. So every day shift wise ఇది అప్ చేస్తూ ఉంటారు కదా సర్వర్స్
nobody will know. Okay. Tell me, ask.
So means no one will start the server, I guess. It will running continuously 24 hours.
Yeah, right? It will run 24/7 for 7 years, 8 years.
Yeah, correct.
When you would like to shut down the server, if it is production, nobody allow you to stop your production server at any cost. If some company in US, if for any reason, if system is down for 1 hour, they have to bear minimum 30, 40 crores rupees loss for that 1 hour, Indian money. The paying basis people to check the server, to keep it up and running only. If basis people, if they won't appoint basis people, system will go down every after 3 days because we need to clean the system every day. Na? We need to check many things in system. The WhatsApp duty, at any cases, for any cause, you never shut down the system. System will not go down from basis point of view. If it is hardware failure, power failure, your UPS is not working, motherboard is not working, RAM gets failed, CPU not working, hard disk gets crashed, some natural calamities happen, that will not count. But from basis side, it should not go down at any cost.
Okay.
Some company appoints 20 basis percentage for small works and paying a huge salaries because they know the importance of the server. Okay. See, I have
and
given
for example, if generally we have to monitor health check of CPU servers, right? CPU
all
utilized.
Servers, all yeah. Servers, yeah.
All servers, DB administrations, these all thing. So we have to check and we have to fill any Excel sheet or what means.
Like Excel sheet only, like plus working, not working, working, not working. That's only.
So every day we have to report to our team lead.
Team lead, and if you feel any hampering on system, like every day CPU you see 40% usage at 10 o'clock in the morning, but certain day you see 50%, no problem. But one day you see 90% usage means you have to inform immediately. And hard disk also, every day you see hard disk utilized, 40%, 42%, but one day you see it was sliding 73%, but in one day 30% utilized. Then you have to inform this to the manager team. Why are you informing? To escalate the thing and solve the things and get all things in normalization. Because we also 15 people working per basis set from our company. So not like when we logged into the system, we need to work for continuous 9 to 10 hours to solve small, big issues. Some days there is no work at all. At that time, we refer some documents. This occurs to what to do. But you never know what error is going to come to you today or tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
There is no fixed schedule for errors. Any error will come at any point of time.
Okay.
Now I'm logging to server and I'll show you how to configure that mailbox.
And sir, what about hierarchy? Means, is there SAP? What is the senior level in SAP? Project manager or senior basis consultant? How would be the hierarchy?
No, hierarchy means like you are a consultant, the senior consultant, then basis lead, team lead, project manager, like that it goes on. Depending upon your
level,
base consultant only, junior consultant.
Okay. And after junior, first, it would be senior consultant, right?
Senior, yeah. Then junior, senior. After that, consultant, lead consultant. Then team lead.
Okay.
Then manage project lead. Then manager, project manager.
Okay.
It all comes through experience only.
Yes, yes. So generally, 3 to 4 experienced guy would cater team lead or lead consultant.
Even 10 years person also work as a senior consultant only if he never jumps to some other company.
Okay.
Even 4 years person work as a basis lead. If he switches 4 companies in 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
See, when you get entry in SAP, it's all up to you how you are going to shift yourself in next 3 years or 4 years.
Okay.
In any company, when you put a paper, nobody stops you. They let you go.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
Scott. In Scott, we have to check this SMTP node. We have to check this SMTP node only. This is a configuration what we need to do. So this is the configuration. what you have to do in configuration. Node is SMTP node and description, like this is a mail server for XYZ Limited. And timing is 10, 20, 30. Somebody gives 5 also. The big company, huge company, they'll give 5 only. They don't have to wait. And this is a mail host. Mail host means here you have to fill your company mail server. Each company has their own email servers. Every company, small or big, they have the webmail, they have the Gmail, they have the webmail server, and they have their domain name for that. Domain name is, if it is XYZ company, XYZ mail.com at the rate, like any name, mail.abc at the rate mailserver.com. It any name they book from the GoDaddy, they will get that name. You have to take name from the client about the mail server and configure it here. Who will give you this name? You will get this name from network team or infra team. In every company, there is a network team who handles the network, because they're working with this all the time, every day. They will properly guide you to what is this and what can be done for this. Okay, now you have to set. What you have to set? You have to click on internet and keep here star. Why this star? If you put star over here, it will receive and send mails from any server anytime. No restrictions. And if you want to put restrictions like only only Ajay will receive mails. Only Suni will receive mail. This happens. If you maintain like this, only these two persons only receive mails in the whole company. If any mails come from Sunil one, Ajay one also, it will not accept, because in address area you have maintained specific email IDs. So what is a better good practice? You have to put a development and quality. When you want to test one or two email IDs at that time, is fine, but in a production server, you have to keep only one star, which suffice. Receive mails from anything and send mails to anything. And in which format it accepts the mails? In which format? It accepts in PDF format, it accepts in STM format, it accepts in STM and TXT. See, there are formats. Yeah, there are formats. There are some formats you have to select. Who will give the format? The team will give the formats key. We have this third party, because for PDF, we need to purchase one tool, PDF converter. But ABAP also, this is a tool. If there are tools, they will inform you key ABACs. We have these tools, you convert, maybe accept and send all these types. You have to ask them, what should I fill this? Just give me a mail confirmation. They will give a mail confirmation saying that key. You can use all these things here. On the base of that, you can use that. But here, you have to maintain star, which I maintain. This is the only main thing. Okay. And one more thing. You maintain this. So last change on 18.4. Okay. When I save this, again, date will change now. See, 28.4 now. Now it is. Where what happened? If somebody done anything, his user ID and the date will come. You can find the guy immediately. If only basis people have authorization to do this hanky-panky things over here. If you share your email user ID password to anybody else, they can hamper you. In worst case, what you can do? You can find this IP address also. If somebody logged in from other laptops with your ID and do some mishapping, then also you can find them through network team, tell network team to find the IP address. They will find IP address for you in worst cases. Okay. So this is about the mail server. This is one thing we have done. Now, how to send mails from here to there? Go to system.
Sir, when we enter into a particular transaction code, so can we find in which transaction code page we are?
Yeah, no, we can easily find out that we are in which transaction code. See from here.
Achha, here down the transaction.
Transaction. The program which is got user client, this will be done. If you use SU01, it will come SU01 over here. And which program is being used in SU01? PFCG, which program in PFCG? Okay.
Okay.
Everything will come from here.
But sir, which server you have given us? Last week we were practicing, but it's not showing there. This down box.
Yeah, it is there. Down box is there, but it's okay. A new server, na? But that's I'll show you where to find that box.
Okay. We'll see later. No issue.
So here you find old small arrow key over. This is the old server. If you see new server here in the corner, you have only one mark like this, small mark. When you click on this, you will get all the information. When I close this, you get close everything.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. We'll check.
This is a message I just want to send to everybody. Now, how to check? You have to write a recipient. Sunil and Anil. I have two names. Here, recipient types. It's very important. You have to see recipient type as internet address. As internet address. Okay, now no forwarding. After sending one, move to outbox. Okay, after sending, move to outbox. Confirm send status always. Okay, you have to send confirmation always. Only if you ask, no, always you have to give a confirmation. So now what I'll do, I have the message ready. Now I have to fire this message. To check my configuration, I have to fire this message. Send. Okay. Now you check what is the position of your things. Go to SOST. Go to SOST. Enter. SOST means it will show you the queue of your existing things. See Anil and Sunil. Anil and Sunil. If your emails coming here means your configuration is done. Confirmed done with coming in perfect manner, So here what happened? It's waiting. Why it's waiting? Because it doesn't find any server, because we don't have any mail server. So it's waiting there. If you have a mail server which you specified, then this will go hit that mail, your mail server, then it will hit the Gmail server. Okay, whenever you send any mails, it will go and hit your webmail server, then that mail server, it will go to destination. Your server is a source server for this, and destination is here. Recipient is destination. First it will go to source, from source it will hit your target, but here we don't have source, so it's showing and waiting the message. If you go to message and see message, long text, this is what, or whatever message you see, message, just click on message, it will show you the perfect error. Okay, and if somebody calls and tell me my mails are not working, not going here and there, then you have to remove all this, and you have to give period from which date to which date, today or yesterday. Yesterday was 26th. Okay, from till today, and you have to see there are no errors. If error comes, what happened? We have to send them, see the message of the error, and try to resolve the issue as early. From here you get the message. See, if I go to status waiting, go to SOST. Yeah, nothing is got selected in our face. Okay, now we have one more thing to discuss. Here we have discussed SOS, SCOT and SOS. Two things are discussed on mail servers, and one more thing. This is the documentation. Okay, I'll share you everything to you. Now the test mail service, see, then you have to this is the way how you configure the job. Which job you have to configure? There's a job which you need to configure. This is a job RSCON01. Write it down somewhere. This is an interview question also. If you schedule this job properly, RSCON01, and if you give time frame 10, 15, 20, 25, depending upon your process, mail will get triggered. This is a very important job. So if I find this job on Google also, what it said, RSCON01. see, R has gone, SAP ABAP report, SAP connect, start send. Started is ABAP program. This is the program by which your mails are received or sent. If this stop, if somebody says job, my job is not working, server is, mails are not sending, so what do you need to check? You need to check whether your this job is activate or not. Go to SM37. You should know the name of the program thing which you are given. I'll just see anything from mail you receive. See, mail server, it's finished, release and finished. If it says failed or cancel, then you have to see immediately. We scheduled it for how much time? I'll show you. See, 5 minutes, every 5 minutes job will get run. Every time the job will run get at every 5 minutes. Last time, now it will trigger at 7:15. See, it will trigger at 7:15, now it is 7:14. They will wait for 1 minute, you'll get fired. See, one more job. 1, 2, 3, 4 are there, na? 5 will come. When one job gets finished, the second will be ready for next release. Once gets finished, second will be there for next release, for next cycle. We will wait 2 minutes and see how these things work. So all these points you have to remember. So DJ seconds 21. Now you just see here, it will send. Here you can see okay, active. You can say ready, active for fraction of seconds. You just see here, I'll refresh. See, finished. Now next release. Now if you see this one, it's done. Now it will be 7:20. 7:50 job is done. Okay. Now what will be? See, now five are there. And new release, sixth one, which is in release rate, it will run at 7:20. Like this, you have to schedule this job. How to know which program you use for this? Go to step and see. This is the program which was set for this. RSCon 01. RSCon 0 is the job program name by which this thing get fired. This is only specially made for sending and receive mails. Understood? So this is what I would like to cover this today, okay?